Welcome to all. Last class we discussed regarding noble gases, electronic configuration and ionization potential, electron gain enthalpy and solubility and adsorption on coconut charcoal and liquefaction and heat of vaporization. Now we are going to discuss, here it is, occurrence means, here it is, availability. Occurrence, this is helium, neon, argon and krypton and xenon and radon. These are the noble gases. In this radon is radioactive element. It is not present in air. Now listen, these all are present in air. In the following, which noble gas not present in air means, that is radon. So now in air, their availability, here it is, first argon greater than, next neon greater than, krypton greater than, helium greater than, xenon. Highest availability argon and least availability in air is xenon. How to remember this is very simple. In alphabets, the first alphabet is A. So here it is, for this you give first number. Next, here it is 2, now this is 3, here it is 4, here it is 5. It is the method to remember. Argon greater than, neon greater than, krypton greater than, helium greater than, xenon. So it is occurrence or availability. Now here it is, some physical properties of these noble gases. Physical properties, these all are gases and monoatomic gases. Helium gas, in this one atom. So for suppose if I take O2, it is diatomic gas, and O3 triatomic gas. So like that, in that gas, how many atoms present? Based on that, here one atom present, that's why these all are monoatomic gases. And the second one, here it is monoatomic gases, these all are odorless and tasteless, comma colorless gases. All noble gases, here it is odorless, tasteless and colorless gases. And the second one, here it is, these are chemically inert. Solubility of these noble gases, we discussed already in the last video. Solubility depends on van der Waals forces. So here it is, all are chemically inert. But listen, here it is, this point, all are chemically inert, but some extraordinary conditions, in this some of the elements forms some compounds. That is only our syllabus, main important syllabus. This helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, all are chemically inert because they contains fulfilled configuration. Here it is 1s2, all contains NS2 NP6 configuration. Because of fulfilled configuration, they are chemically inert. But in these also some are forms compounds in some extraordinary conditions. Here it is, listen, which forms compounds in this. Listen, compounds in this means, for suppose sodium chloride forming compound. Sodium chloride forming compound means sodium lose one electron, chlorine gains one electron. Between sodium and chlorine, force of attraction present. So sodium chloride is the compound. So here also listen, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, top to bottom when we go, here it is, top to bottom, atomic radius increases. Ionization potential is inversely proportional to atomic radius. Here ionization potential is inversely proportional to atomic radius. Top to bottom atomic radius increasing means ionization potential decreasing. Ionization potential decreasing means xenon is very less ionization potential. So xenon very less ionization potential means xenon is very less ionization potential means among these noble gases. Among this helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, xenon is very less noble, sorry, very less ionization potential. So compared to helium, neon, argon, krypton, from xenon we can remove electrons easily. So here it is xenon. Then xenon ionization potential is less, but even though we have to remember xenon is a noble gas, so that is not that much easy to remove electrons from the valency of xenon. So we have to take the higher electronegativity atom to remove electrons from this. So here it is, first of all, to create the compounds of noble gases, first scientist selected xenon. Why they selected xenon means its ionization potential is less. At the same time, which are forms compounds with xenon means one is fluorine, another one is oxygen. Why fluorine and oxygen forms compounds with xenon means xenon is a noble gas configuration, so its ionization potential is high, but compared to helium, neon, argon, krypton, less. So from the stable configuration of xenon, to remove electrons, higher electronegativity atoms required. So two higher electronegativity atoms, one is fluorine, another one is oxygen. Here xenon forms compounds with fluorine, those are xenon fluorides. Xenon forms compounds with oxygen, those are xenon oxides. Xenon also forms compounds with oxygen and fluorine at a time, those are xenon oxyfluorides. Totally three type of compounds there: xenon fluorides, xenon oxides, xenon oxyfluorides. Three type of compounds we are going to discuss. But here it is, first how they started compounds with these noble gases. Here it is, first he is the scientist Bartlett. He first prepared, this is O2 and this is PTF6, platinum hexafluoride. When they treated O2 and PTF6, they created a compound O2 plus and PTF6 minus. O2 plus PTF6 minus, one compound they prepared. Here it is, listen, O2 oxidation state 0, here O2 oxidation state plus 1. Means they removed one electron from this O2. So removal of one electron from isolated gaseous atom, that is ionization potential. Now here, what is the ionization potential? That is comparable ionization potential with xenon. Immediately the scientists, they got doubt. Instead of O2, if we use xenon, maybe such like compound is possible. Then they tried with xenon, they created a compound xenon plus PTF6 gives rise to Xe plus and PTF6 minus 1. Like this compound they prepared. So it is here it is xenon, first compound this is. Not only this xenon, with krypton also they prepared one compound, that is KrF2. So and here it is, with this helium, neon, argon, there is no compounds. Question they will ask in the following, which compound is yet now not known. So here it is, helium, neon, argon compounds are not known. Krypton compound, one compound they prepared, that is KrF2. Here it is, xenon compounds are Xe plus PTF6 minus 1. In the form, what is the first xenon compound? XePTF6. So this is the first successful reaction to give an initiation for helium compounds. So now we are going to discuss xenon compounds. Why xenon only forms compounds means xenon, its ionization potential is less. So among all noble gases, xenon ionization potential less. So we are removing electrons from xenon. For that, we selected higher electronegativity atoms like fluorine and oxygen. So first here I am taking xenon compounds. In that xenon compounds, first we are discussing about fluorides. Here first I am taking here it is xenon. Its electronic configuration is 5s2 5p6. It is ground state configuration. Here 5s2, two electrons paired, lone pair. 5p6, here six electrons all are paired in the form of 3. So here it is 2 pairs, here 3 pairs. So here it is in ground state, xenon does not form any compounds. So now I am writing xenon first excited configuration. First excited configuration means one electron I am lifting from this 5p to 5d. So here electronic configuration, first excited state configuration, 5s2 and 5p5 and 5d1. So here it is 5s2 and 5p5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 5d1. So this is first excited configuration. FES means first excited configuration. Xenon in its first excited configuration, it contains two. These are single electrons. Those we called bonded electrons. Two bonded electrons, and here it is these three there. Three present as lone pairs. Three lone pairs and two bonded electrons. Now here it is xenon, second excited state. Second excited state means one more electron we have to lift from 5p to 5d. So here it is xenon, this is 5s2, 5p4 and 5d2. Here it is xenon, 5s2, this is 5p4 and 5d2. So now in second excited state, it contains, this is four bonded electrons, and these two are lone pairs. Now I am taking here it is xenon third excited state. One more electron I am lifting from 5p to 5d. So this become 5s2 and 5p3, 5s2, 5p3 and 5d3. So it is 5s2 and 5p3 and 5d3. This is third excited state. In third excited state, the xenon valency contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 bonded electrons. These are not pairs, 6 bonded electrons. And here it contains one lone pair. It is third excited state. And in xenon fourth excited state, again this lone pair, one electron I am shifting. From this lone pair, one electron I am shifting 5s2, 5d. So now configuration in fourth excited state, 5s1, 5p3 and 5d4. Here it is 5s1 and 5p3, 1, 2, 3 and 5d4. Here it contains totally 8 bonded electrons. So totally xenon ground state, there was no bonded electrons, that's why no bonds. Xenon in its first excited state contains two bonded electrons. Two bonded electrons means it forms two bonds. So it is one fluorine here, another fluorine here. Here possibility is for XeF2. Now here it is, this is second excited state. Second excited state here it is, four bonded electrons. So four bonds possible. So four bonds possible means here the compound possible is XeF4. Here it is third excited state. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 bonded electrons. So 6 bonds possible. Here it is XeF6. Here it is 8 bonded electrons. But we expect XeF8. But 8 bonds are very rare. So that's why here it is XeF8 is not possible. So total xenon compounds are XeF2, XeF4, XeF6. XeF8 is not possible because this 8 bonds are very rare. So now here it is in this carefully reason. XeF2. So after formation of XeF2, these two formed two bonds. So xenon forming two bonds with two fluorines. These three are lone pairs. Means XeF2 contains three lone pairs. XeF4 contains two lone pairs. XeF6 contains one lone pair. So now the structure of XeF2, XeF4 and XeF6. We are discussing xenon compounds. In that we are discussing regarding fluorides. In that fluorides, structures of fluorides. First I am taking here it is XeF2. XeF2, in that XeF2 the central atom is xenon. Here it is xenon is the central atom. And here it is fluorine and here it is fluorine. Xenon, its valency contains 8 electrons. In that 8 electrons, 2 electrons, 1 electron this side bond, 1 electron this side bond. So, out of 8 electrons, 2 electrons formed bonds. So, 6 electrons remaining. 6 electrons remaining means there was 3 lone pairs. 3 lone pairs, here it is 1 lone pair, here it is 1 more lone pair, here it is 1 more lone pair. This is XeF2 structure. Here it is reason, what is the hybridization? Hybridization is equal to sigma bonds plus lone pair. Sigma bonds, 2 sigma bonds and the lone pairs are 3, 1, 2, 3. 2 plus 3, here it is, totally this is 5. It's a steric number 5. Steric number 5 means hybridization is sp3d. sp3d hybridization. Here it is regarding sp3d I am explaining. sp3d, here it is, I am writing lone pairs and bond pairs and geometry and here it is shape. Steric number here it is 5. Here I am taking totally 5 bond pairs and 0 lone pairs. sp3d structure means geometry is trigonal bipyramidal, shape also trigonal bipyramidal when 0 lone pairs present. Now I am taking this is 4, here it is 1. This is trigonal bipyramidal and here it is, what is the shape? The shape is here it is A, X, X, here it is X, X and X. Here it is, this is trigonal, above one pyramidal, below one pyramidal, trigonal bipyramidal. Here it is lone pair where we have to place. Lone pair we have to place where bond angle is more. Here it is, these are equatorial, equatorial, equatorial. This is axial, this is axial. Equatorial, between equatorial bond angle is 120 degrees. Equatorial axial bond angle is 90 degrees. So 120 degrees is the bigger angle. So that's why here one of the equatorial position I am replacing with lone pair. Please remember carefully, lone pairs where we have to place, that is the very important objective question.
in your geometry, where bond angle is more, that is either equatorial or axial, whatever it may be, where bond angle is more, those there we has to place lone pair. For suppose in sp3d structure, trigonal bipyramidal, here it is, these three are equatorial position, these two are axial position. Now equatorial to equatorial bond angle 120, equatorial to axial bond angle is 90. 120 is the greater bond angle, so that's why I am placing lone pairs at equatorial position. And here it is, I am taking, this is pentagonal bipyramidal structure, it is A, X, 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 X. It is pentagonal bipyramidal. This is pentagonal. One X is towards you, one X is away from you. Here also, this one X is towards you, one X is away from you. On board, up and down, I am writing. This is triangle. Triangle you take along the board plane. From the triangle center to one X towards you, one X away from you. That is trigonal bipyramidal structure. Here also, this is pentagonal, you take along the board plane, and one X is towards you, one X is away from you. So means back side of this board. So here it is, this is equatorial, this is equatorial, and this is equatorial, equatorial, equatorial. Five equatorial positions. And this is axial and this is axial position. Now my question is, equatorial to equatorial bond angle in pentagonal. In this pentagonal, this equatorial to equatorial bond angle is 72 degrees. But equatorial to axial bond angle is 90 degrees. Why? Because this pentagonal you take along the board plane, and this one X is towards you. So the X which is towards you, that is axial. The pentagonal which is along the board, that is equatorial. So this board to towards you like this present means, here bond angle is 90 degrees. Here it is like this present. From one A to one X towards you, one X is away from you. From this board to here bond angle is 90 degrees. So here it is, equatorial to equatorial 120. Here equatorial to equatorial 72. Here equatorial axial 90. Here also equatorial axial 90. So here it is, axial bond angle is 90 is greater than equatorial. Here axial bond angle 90 is lesser than equatorial. Here in trigonal bipyramidal, the more bond angle we are getting in equatorial position. That's why we replace lone pairs in equatorial position. In pentagonal bipyramidal, the more bond angle we are getting in axial position. So we replace first in axial positions. So here it is, one thing here it is, lone pairs we have to replace where bond angle is more. You don't say always we have to replace lone pairs at equatorial positions, always we have to replace at axial positions, not like that. We have to replace lone pairs where bond angle is more. So here it is, this is the bond angle, here it is, bond angle more, this equatorial position I am replacing with lone pair. So now this is seesaw structure. Now I am taking, here it is, this is 3, here it is 2, 3 plus 2, 5 and 5. This geometry will not change. So now here it is, this is X, trigonal bipyramidal structure. Now 2 lone pairs present, these 2 equatorial positions I am replacing with lone pairs. So this knot involves in shape. Now the shape is T shape. Here it is T shape. Now here it is. This is 4 bond pairs. Here it is 2 bond pairs and 3 lone pairs. 3 plus 2, 5 and 5. So now this is also I am replacing with lone pair. Now my shape is geometry trigonal bipyramidal. Shape is linear. So here it is linear shape. So this is the linear shape. SP3D hybridization, here it is, first you take geometry is trigonal bipyramidal and shape is linear shape. And here it is linear shape, this is the linear shape. Sometimes they ask the question,
what is the shape of lone pairs? Shape of the lone pair is trigonal. Shape of the lone pair is trigonal or triangle. And here it is, this molecule shape is linear. Linear shape. So it is regarding XeF2. Now I am going for XeF4. XeF4 in this central atom is xenon. Central atom is xenon. And here it is, 4 fluorines there. So means 4 bonds over. 4 bonds over means remaining 4 bonds there. Sorry, 4 electrons there. 4 electrons means 2 lone pairs. So here it is, this is one lone pair, here it is another lone pair, here it is fluorine, fluorine, fluorine and fluorine. This is the rough structure I am giving to you. It is XeF4. Actual geometry we get after got the hybridization. So for perfect geometry and perfect shape, I am taking XeF4 in this hybridization is sigma bonds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 5, 6 means here it is sp3d2. sp3d2, regarding sp3d2, here it is sp3d2, steric number is 6. Again I am taking lone pair, and here it is bond pair, here it is geometry, here it is shape. So like this. First I am taking, this is 6 bond pairs and 0 lone pairs. It is octahedral structure. Sorry, octahedral geometry. Shape also octahedral. Now I am taking, this is bond pairs 5 and lone pairs 1. So bond pairs 5, lone pairs 1 means here geometry will not change octahedral. And here it is how the shape will change. The shape is, for suppose, what is octahedral structure? In octahedral structure, it is, this is one square. Center you take, the center point, you take one A. X, X, X and X. One X towards you, one X away from you. So here it is totally, this is AX, 6 type. A, X, 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 X. 1X towards you, 1X away from you. AX6 type octahedral structure that is. Here it is 5 bond pairs, 1 lone pair. 5 bond pairs means 5 bonds and 1 lone pair. This is A, X, X and X and X. 4 over. And back side 1X I am taking. Front side 1 lone pair. This lone pair does not involve in shape. Now your structure is, here it is A, X, 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 X. Here one X is there. So it is square, it is pyramidal. Your shape here it is square pyramidal. And here it is, I am taking, this is 4 and this is 2, this is octahedral. So means this side also I am replacing lone pair, this side also I am replacing lone pair. Now square only remains there. So now structure is, this is square planar. Square planar structure. So now here it is, this XeF6 present in which geometry? Octahedral. So here it is, geometry is octahedral and the shape is square planar. Square planar means here it is, this is XE. This is the square. And planar, here it is square planar structure. And these two lone pairs, one is towards you, one is away from you. I am writing here it is, this is if you are taken towards you, this is away from you. This is totally XeF6 structure. Here also they will ask, what is the XeF6 shape, means square planar. What is the geometry of XeF6? What is the geometry of XeF6 means we have to consider these two lone pairs also, that is octahedral. Now what is the shape of lone pairs in XeF4?
What is the shape of lone pairs in XEF4 means linear. Once again, here it is XEF4. Here it is xenon with 4 bonds. Here it is 4, 2 lone pairs. SP3D, octahedral geometry, square planar. Here it is, this is the square, these two are the lone pairs, square planar structure. Questions, XEF4 molecule shape, square planar. XEF4 molecule geometry, octahedral. In XEF4, what is the shape of lone pairs, means linear. So this is lone pairs, shape is linear shape. So it is regarding XEF4. Next, XEF6. While you are writing, please pause the video and just copy and continue. XEF6. XEF6. Here also first I am taking rough structure, then I go for perfect geometry and perfect shape. Here this is xenon. This is xenon, here it is 6. Fluorine, fluorine, here it is fluorine, here it is fluorine, fluorine and fluorine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, xenon valency 8, 6 bonds there means, here it is one lone pair, here it is another lone pair. It is a rough structure I given to you. Perfect geometry and shape, I am taking hybridization. Sigma bonds plus lone pair. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 sigma bonds. Here it is sigma bonds plus lone pair for hybridization. 6 sigma bonds plus 1 lone pair. This is totally 7. 7 means sp3d3. sp3d3. So regarding this sp3d3, here it is sp3d3. sp3d3 6. Here it is I am taking lone pair and bond pair. And here it is geometry and here it is shape. Here it is 6 bond pairs and 0 lone pairs. Just now only we discussed that is pentagonal bipyramidal. Shape also pentagonal bipyramidal. Why? Because bond pairs are 6, lone pairs are 0. Now I am taking bond pairs 5 and this is 1. So this is pentagonal bipyramidal. One lone pair, where I have to replace equatorial or axial? Axial we have to replace here. Why? Because axial bond angle is 90, equatorial bond angle is 72 degrees. So axial if I substitute there, here it is, I get, here it is square, sorry, pentagonal bipyramidal, pentagonal pyramidal structure I get. Pentagonal pyramidal, here it is bipyramidal, here monopyramidal will come. Why monopyramidal will come means one of the pyramid I am replacing with lone pair. So that does not involve in shape. So pentagonal pyramidal. Pentagonal pyramidal, this is only we called distorted octahedral. Why I am explaining these are this much easily, this many times. The reason is, you no need to muck up this. If you muck up also so many areas, you have to explain the geometry and shape for different molecules. This is a process, not a particular topic. We learn this is in chemical bond, but this method we have to use so many areas. So we have to get a perfect command on this. Hybridization and what is the geometry, what is the shape, how it, you don't remember this is a 6-0 pentagonal bipyramidal like that. No, here we have to understand, then only we can give the perfect structures even though question is changed. So it is distorted octahedral. So here it is, this is totally distorted octahedral structure. So here it is, this is information about XEF6. Here also XEF6 perfect shape if you want. You take, here it is, this is XE, here it is XE, this is fluorine, fluorine, fluorine,
fluorine, here it is fluorine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, HCF6. And I am writing here also, here it is. Here I am writing one lone pair. This side I am writing one fluorine. The meaning here very simple. This pentagon along the board plane. This one lone pair towards you, this one fluorine is away from you. This is totally pentagonal monopyramidal. For that only we write as distorted octahedral. Why distorted octahedral? Means here it is, if we just like this, if we are taken, this fluorine, if we are taken back side, this fluorine front side, this is will come as octahedral structure. From octahedral to distorted, that's why we called distorted octahedral shape. This is information about HCF6. So HCF2, HCF4 and HCF6. Now chemical properties of these. Chemical properties. Mainly this xenon fluorides involves in hydrolysis reaction. Here two type of hydrolysis we has to read. One is partial hydrolysis, another one is, sorry, before this preparation we discussed about HCF2, HCF4, HCF6 structures, but preparation first you complete the preparation. Preparation, very simple preparation. Xenon plus F2 gives rise to HCF2. Xenon plus 2F2 gives rise to HCF4. Xenon plus 3F2 gives rise to HCF6. But listen, here it is. In one vessel, I am taking xenon and I am passing, here it is, excess of fluorine. In this vessel I get HCF2, HCF4, HCF6, like that three mixture I get, here it is. But it is not the funda here, we has to prepare HCF2 separately, HCF4 separately, HCF6 separately. So to get separate, the scientific method is, here this is, we has to take 2:1 ratio. This is xenon and fluorine. This is volume ratio, I am telling. It is experimental information. Volume ratio. Volume ratio, xenon and fluorine, 2:1 ratio if we take. Here it is, 673 Kelvin temperature, 6 atm pressure. In presence of nickel catalyst, we reacted xenon and fluorine in 2:1 volume ratio. Then we get HCF2. Here it is, 673 Kelvin temperature and 7 atm pressure in presence of nickel catalyst. If we take 1:5 ratio, 1:5 volume ratio, then we get HCF4. And here it is, same 573 Kelvin temperature, 60-70 atm pressure in presence of nickel catalyst. 573 Kelvin temperature, 60-70 atm pressure at nickel catalyst. If we take xenon and fluorine, 1:20 volume ratio, then we get HCF6. It is method to prepare separate HCF2, HCF4 and HCF6. But simply if we take xenon and sending excess quantity of fluorine, those two react to mixture of HCF2 and HCF4 and HCF6. So now I am giving chemical properties. Chemical properties of these xenon fluorides. Mainly these involves in hydrolysis reaction. Two type of hydrolysis, they ask the question. What is hydrolysis? Simple, they given hydrolysis means that is perfect hydrolysis, complete hydrolysis. Partial hydrolysis means we use limited quantity of water. First I am explaining, here it is, complete hydrolysis. Complete hydrolysis, here it is, HCF2 plus H2, HCF4 plus H2O. Here it is HCF6 plus H2O. All hydrolysis, this is complete hydrolysis I am explaining. Complete hydrolysis, here it is, the products here it is 2, right? This I am taking 2, here it is 2. This I am taking 2, here it is 4 moles. This is 2, here it is 6 moles. Just you follow second table to get this information. 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 2 threes are 6. Complete hydrolysis. And here to write the products, we have to understand xenon forms 2 oxides, XeO2 and XeO3. It does not form XeO4. Why? Because again 8 bonds. In these two, the stable one is XeO3. XeO2, XeO3, the stable one is XeO3. So, when here it is xenon undergoing hydrolysis, this xenon fluorides undergoing hydrolysis, there was a chance to get XeO2 and XeO3, but we have to give importance to XeO3. Why? Because compared to XeO2, XeO3 is more stable. Here this is, I am taking 2, 3 is 6. So means XeF6 plus 3H2O. One xenon with 3 oxygens, here XeO3 is the product plus. So one xenon, 3 oxygens, XeO3. Here 6 fluorines, 6 hydrogens. So now my product is 6 moles of H. And here it is 2 xenon and 4 oxygens. There is no chance to form 2 moles of XeO3. So 1 xenon you take and 3 oxygens, here the product is XeO3 plus. 1 xenon remaining there, that xenon here it is plus. 4 twos are 8, 2 fours are 8. Here it is 8 HF and 1 oxygen is there, that is come out as half O2. It is XeO3 and XE8HF and half O2. Now this also, here also, here there was no chance to form XeO3. So that's why simply here it is 2 moles of xenon plus. Here it is 2 twos are 4, 2 twos are 4. That is 4 moles of HF plus. Here it is oxygen, O2. So this is the products. Very simple, you just go through with the second table, you give importance to xenon trioxide. So here it is, question they will ask in the following, which xenon fluoride does not give oxygen on hydrolysis, that is XeF6. Which gives oxygen means, that is XeF2 and XeF4. Here oxygen and oxygen. So this is complete hydrolysis. Now I am going with the partial hydrolysis. Partial hydrolysis means, first suppose XeF2 2 moles water means here it is complete hydrolysis. 4 moles water means complete hydrolysis. Here it is 3 moles water means complete hydrolysis. If I am using 1 mole, here it is less than 4 moles, less than 3 moles I am using means that is partial hydrolysis. On partial hydrolysis, what are the products? First I am taking this XeF4. XeF4, partial hydrolysis I am explaining. Partial hydrolysis means here it is, I am taking 2 moles of water. If I am taking 2 moles of water, here it is, how many oxygens there? 2 oxygens. 2 oxygens here, that replace here it is 4 fluorines. Here it is 2 twos are 4 and 4, that's why here it is 4 moles of HF plus. Now here it is 2 oxygens, each oxygen forms double bond. So totally here the product is XeO2, xenon dioxide. Simple, very simple to write the products, 2 twos are 4 and 4. So 4 HF, now 2 oxygens there, 2 oxygens there, XeO2. So now this XeO2, regarding this XeO2. Actually, xenon fluorides, xenon oxides also I am explaining simultaneously. Here it is xenon, its valency 8, 2 oxygens means 4 bonds over. So 4 bonds over, here it is oxygen and oxygen. Here it is 1, 2, 3, 4 means remaining 4 bonds means 2 lone pairs. Here it is 1 lone pair, here it is another lone pair. Now perfect geometry and shape to get hybridization. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 means sp3. sp3 with two lone pairs means that is tetrahedral structure, sorry, tetrahedral geometry and bent shape. Tetrahedral geometry and which shape? That is bent shape. Bent shape means this is xenon, here it is oxygen, here it is oxygen, this side one lone pair and this side another lone pair. It is information about XeO2. Here it is one water molecule I am using, XeF4 plus H2O. XeF4 plus H2O gives rise to, here it is again, two hydrogens, two fluorines. Instead of 4HF, we get 2HF plus XeOF2. XeOF2. Xenon oxyfluoride. So XeOF2 here also, first of all, I am taking this is rough diagram. XE, here it is OFF. 1, 2, 3, 4 means two lone pairs. It is rough geometry and rough shape like that you take. And now here perfect geometry and perfect shape. Sigma plus lone 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 4, 5 means that is sp3d. sp3d means here it is. This is trigonal bipyramidal. Trigonal bipyramidal, two lone pairs there. Trigonal bipyramidal, two lone pairs means shape is T shape. So XeOF2 present in which shape? T shape. T shape, if you want, here it is XE, here it is fluorine, here it is fluorine, here it is double bond O, here this is lone pair, here this is the lone pair. This is which shape? T shape. So it is XeOF2. So two water molecules, one water molecule. If I use 4 water molecules, this is 2 moles means that is complete hydrolysis. So now here it is, this is XeF. I am taking XeF6. If I take XeF6, if I use complete hydrolysis, I am taking 3H2O. If I take 3H2O, 3 to the 6 and 6, this is not partial hydrolysis. Complete hydrolysis, 6 moles of HF, 3 to the 6 and 6. What is the product? XeO3. Now this XeO3 structure. XeO3 structure, first rough geometry, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So one lone pair. To get perfect geometry and perfect shape, 1, 2, 3, 4. So here it is, which hybridization? sp3. 1, 2, 3, 4. sp3. sp3 with one lone pair. Here first geometry is tetrahedral and shape is pyramidal shape. So pyramidal shape, here it is. This is XE. This is one lone pair. Here it is oxygen, oxygen and oxygen. It is the pyramidal shape. So it is XeO3. This is complete hydrolysis, pyramidal shape of XeO3. Now partial hydrolysis I am taking. Partial hydrolysis, less than 3 moles if I take. Partial hydrolysis of XeF6. XeF6 plus, instead of 3 moles of water, I am using 2 moles of water. Chalo. It is 2 and 2, 4 and 4. Here it is 4 moles of HF. 4 moles of HF means here it is 2 fluorines remaining, that is XeO2F2. XeO2F2, it is also xenon, oxygen, oxygen, here it is fluorine, here it is fluorine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 means one lone pair. So to get perfect geometry and shape, here it is hybridization, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 means sp3d. sp3d means trigonal bipyramidal. One lone pair there. That's why this structure is seesaw structure. Seesaw shape. sp3d, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. sp3d trigonal bipyramidal geometry and shape is seesaw. So this is information about partial hydrolysis. And here we covered also xenon oxides and oxyfluorides. This is total information about xenon compounds. Now here it is, one important point is, if you take xenon fluorides, they will ask question, what is the shape of HCF2? Last year question is, in NEET, what is the shape of HCF2, HCF4, F3, F6 in the following? HCF2, HCF4, HCF6, the shape in the following. So, four options they given. So, direct question that is. Here it is one important topic, here it is. This is HCF2 and HCF4 and HCF6. These are the xenon fluorides. This contains 3 lone pairs. This contains 2 lone pairs. This contains 1 lone pair. Means all are contains minimum 1 lone pair. So lone pair present means these all are lone pair donors. Lone pair donors means these act as Lewis base. All HCF2, HCF4, HCF6, all are Lewis bases. Act as Lewis bases because they contains minimum 1 lone pair donors, Lewis bases. I am explaining about HCF2, HCF4, HCF6. You take HCO2, HCO3, HCOF2, HCO2F2, whatever you take, the same method you have to follow to explain Lewis basic character and Lewis acidic character. And this is one side. And another side, listen here it is, you take HCF2 or HCF4 or HCF6, this is first excited state, second excited state, this is third excited state. After your excitation got over, these all contains empty d orbitals. Here, these all are contains empty d orbitals. Empty d orbitals. Empty d orbitals present, these accept lone pair. Lone pair acceptor is Lewis acid. That meaning, because of lone pairs, these act as Lewis bases. Because of empty d orbitals, these act as Lewis acids. So, but here question is, in which conditions they act as Lewis bases, in which condition they act as Lewis acids? Listen carefully, HCF2, HCF4, HCF6, these are the lone pair numbers. Lone pairs present means they donate lone pairs, so that's why they act as Lewis bases. At the same time, you take HCF2, HCF4, HCF6. All are contains empty d orbitals. If you are not getting clarity, first excited state after HCF2, empty orbitals there in your configuration. HCF4 empty orbitals there, HCF6 also empty orbitals there. So empty d orbitals present, that's why these compounds accepts lone pairs into these empty d orbitals. That's why they act as Lewis acids also. Now, where these act as Lewis acids, where these act as Lewis bases. Listen carefully, here it is. I am taking HCF2. HCF2, I am taking, here it is, PF5. One PF5 molecule I am taking. Same way, here it is, I am taking HCF2 plus CSF I am taking. Here, listen carefully, this is ionic compound. One ionic compound, one covalent compound I am taking. This is ionic. CS plus 1 and F minus 1. This is, here it is, covalent compound. Here in phosphorus also empty orbitals present. Here it is CS plus 1, F minus 1. This F minus taken by this HCF2. So HCF2 means F minus means it is gaining electrons. So gaining lone pair. So it is gaining lone pair means, how I know, sir, how you know it is gaining lone pair? Means this negative charge is there, this is lifting into xenon. So in xenon, this electron enters into empty d orbitals only. So means HCF2 lone pair acceptor. Lone pair acceptor means act as Lewis acid. Lewis acid means this HCF2 with F minus, that become HCF3 minus 1. And here it is CS plus 1. Together this compound is CSXEF3, like this compound will come. Why? Because plus and minus total cancel out, it is the product. Here listen in this, this compound is not your criteria. Here your point is, This xenon compound acting as Lewis acid or Lewis base. It is acting as Lewis acid. With ionic compounds, it acts as Lewis acid. Now I am taking covalent compounds. In this covalent compounds, it donate one F minus to this. So F minus into this means, this F minus, that negative charge, that negative electrons, electrons are lifting into empty d orbital of phosphorus. Here lifted into empty d orbital of xenon. Here they are lifting into empty d orbital of phosphorus. So now it is lone pair donor. That's why this is Lewis base. It acts as Lewis acid. So now here our product is, it is donating one F minus. So XeF. XeF plus 1 plus PF6 minus 1. So here it is Lewis base. With ionic compounds act as Lewis acid. With covalent compounds act as Lewis base. It is the total information about xenon compounds, total noble gases. Just some in NCERT textbook, this helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon uses there. That uses, you just read from 3-4 points there, read from NCERT textbook. Thank you.